Hello. So I think I discovered what the issue is. I think I'm just stupid. I think you have to have a steel. I think you have to have a steel ingot in your inventory, and then Balamon's closed. I just checked, so we're gonna find out together. Probably 14. God, that's so nice, dude. I'm so glad somebody taught me that. That's so crazy useful. That's maybe my lighting mod is causing this. It's not chugging as bad right now, though. I fully restarted
Come
my
see back
computer.
the finest weapons and armor.
Does he even have any? Let's try. Oof. I almost hate to spend that much because Breeze Home on its own is 9K, and then all of the upgrades come out to like 3K.
Need any more smithing work? Come see me again.
Yeah, okay, so you have to have a steel ingot in your inventory. And it makes 5 now, which I actually don't
Jewelry with
like
legendary
that
Italian
change.
craftsmanship.
But it is what it
Always
is.
worth seeing.
I'm gonna keep it
Come
what it is right
on.
now. Or I'm gonna keep as many as I have right now, which is
Offer one
17.
will accept. Only
That
20 servings.
17 feels a little bit more comfortable than 12, because I know there's a few apprentice locks in there. I could have taken the carriage, but I just can't be bothered. 161. I know I was just complaining about money, and it would have only been, I think, 80 to go here, but I just can't be bothered to take the few extra steps. But yeah, we're gonna do Bleak Falls in this one. So I have. See, it lasts 30 minutes, and I don't know if I can pop it and use another one in there and then not run out. But I think I'm going to. The Mitonic is a while, right? Hour and 10 minutes. Okay. Oh, you know what? Hopefully, I don't need to console anything else, because that way I can keep my horse in case he dies for that super long time that I'm going to be in there. I maybe should have ridden my horse up here, actually. Maybe I will, actually. So now we're pretty dwarven, which I like. Everything but our gloves, because the Iron Hand Gauntlets are just way too good. Not too good as in they need a nerf, but they are definitely like best in slot for a while. I think the boss himself is hard enough to justify how good they are, but maybe not. I don't know. I could see them being moved to somebody like Elsie the Spiker, because she doesn't have. I think she might have unique enchanted gear now, but for the longest time she didn't. She was basically just a challenge boss, but didn't give you anything. So, and since she's also two-handed, she might be a good candidate for the Iron Hand Gauntlets, just saying. Because then it's like an even further. Because I haven't even done Valheim yet. Because there's nothing that I really want there. So.
Now, ain't this a
I don't know if
surprise?
you guys are hearing my Discord go off. My friend asked if I wanted a game and then doesn't reply, so I'm like, okay, well, I'm gonna record then. And I'm back to playing like a scrub. Let's go. Wow, those arrows hurt. I actually lost half my health, surprisingly.
I'll show you what a real war can do.
Oh, now my visuals are. What is going on, dude? Something's going on with my. Something's going on with my visuals here. I don't understand. Dude, look at that. Something happened to my textures. I might have to. If everywhere is like this, I might have to figure out what's going on. bro. And I don't know what would have caused my... This is almost like corrupt data or something. I mean, I get minor visual bugs like that every once in a while, but this particular play session's been extra bad. Oh, I still haven't regenerated to full. So I'm gonna pop fortify health, but probably not this early. Make sure there's no trick. Sometimes there's a trickster here, sometimes there isn't. So. Yeah, see, I'm still having texture issues. I don't know. I mean, I did remove mods mid playthrough, but it was like. I removed Royal Armory, Heavy Armory, and Immersive Armors. Like, I removed all of my armor mods, that's it. But we're having major, major texture issues here, so. We'll see what the inside looks like. And if it's still jacked up on the inside, I'm probably gonna have to just make this a super short one and. Maybe full restart my computer and see if that helps. I don't know. Yeah, my floor, all my ground looks really weird. I'm gonna kill these bandits and then I'm going to switch to my silver warhammer. Challenge. I mean, I don't really expect anything in here to be all that challenging. Oh, I've gotten positive 4 lockpicks since making them. But yeah, if it's only going to make 5, all that does is just encourage me to mine twice as much corundum and iron, which I'll probably do after this. So, it's kind of a... Or I'll just go back and change it to 10. Is probably much more likely. I had forgotten, otherwise I would have changed it. Because I have my own tweak mod. I don't remember if I mentioned this before. I have my own tweak mod that I'm working on. Basically just changes very few things. Some things that I just don't like about. Oh, I would definitely want to take the silver sword still, because it breaks down into a silver ingot. Like, if I wanted to be even more cheap, I could have come here, taken the silver sword, and then gone back. But I don't care that much. But I do care enough to do this. Just for carry weight issues. He's gonna clip into the wall, so I'm gonna have to walk further away. Yeah, major, major environment text issues, so I... Or texture issues, so... I don't know. I still can't drop 30. Oh, because it weighs 34. Well, I'm taking both of these anyways. They add up to almost the same. That's pretty funny. Even with both of these weapons. Because I'm going to have to find out. Because this does 28 additional damage to undead. And it's a bladed weapon. But it's also unperked. And it's iron. Is the enchantment showing that it's drained? Because I haven't used it at all, but it looks like it's showing that it's drained, so it probably doesn't even have the enchant. So, I believe that's the... Do I have another enchanted weapon to check? My Dwemer crossbow I know for sure is drained. And... So that is definitely drained. Because that would have been really useful to flee for 5 seconds, because I think the boss isn't even 28, so it would work against him. But I'll carry it until I need the carry weight, just in case. But I mean, you can't recharge without the first perk in enchanting, so. Which I'm not gonna take, I don't think. But like I said before, I don't know what I'm gonna use for my end game. Weapon. I don't know yet, because obviously Volendrung would be a good choice for this character, but you can't take Volendrung with Jigalag. So it's really gonna be trying to figure out what weapon I wanna use is what's gonna be the questionable thing right now. So how many lockpicks do I have? Yes, I only have 18. So somebody's got, I mean, I can take a few bone meals because they make resist fire. Obviously want to kill this guy that because he's worth diluted. Good old Bleak Falls. I believe this is another apprentice, yeah. Cool. Oh, and a potion of fortified carry weight, I'll take that. Get the dexterity book. I don't know why I'm taking soul gems, to be honest. I guess because they sell for a decent, but. Fireball, yeah. Probably use that against the boss. Wow, this thing drains so much less stamina. Is there another one? Yes. Now what's funny is I think I can actually fight the spider. Like, straight up, because he can't. Oh cool, can I just pick it through here? Because he can't, like, his spit, I don't believe, does anything to me. Bruh. So he could potentially knock me down, I guess. But I think my armor is so high that I'm really tempted to fight him in melee and see how it goes. So, wish me luck. Fortify health. I have a good and a remarkable. We'll pop the good right now. Puts me at 244. Not bad. Yeah, this thing's getting jacked up. So, that was the Frostbite Spider. I'll take all that, actually.
Don't leave me for RK's sake. It's coming loose. I can
I'll make sure I have enough stamina left to power attack him. Okay. Okay. Draugr time. Now let's once again review what my MR is. Whoops. 40%, so I'm 5% shy of having enough to resist Unrelenting Force. I believe it's 45. I believe it's 45. It might be 35, but I'm pretty sure it's 45. So, if I see a shouter, I definitely want to, definitely want to still be careful. So, one thing that I'm still not willing to test is how much an unblocked power attack will do from a Draugr. Oh, that is not a lot of damage. Oh, nothing. Okay. Well, that, I mean, that was a one-handed, but still. I might just have to hit trade. Oh, that hurt. Not a ton, but. Yeah, they hurt. Not a ton, but they do hurt. Oh, I didn't think you'd clip me there. I put my guard back down. Okay, well, enough messing around. Let's actually pay attention. Unfortunately, they take very little damage. He's only taking like 90 damage. So it might be a lot of trap cheesing here. I knew I was gonna get hit by the second one, but it was also a guaranteed hit I could land on him. So this is gonna be slow. I could pop a healing potion, I just don't really feel like going through all of my healing potions right now. And then I try to loot a body mid-combat. Okay, maybe I will, I guess. I have a lot, but I mean, these are literally the first three Draugr, so. Yeah, damage is nowhere near as much as I would have liked. I mean, I do only have 25 two-handed, but I'm hitting them for like 90 with a Warhammer, which does kind of feel bad. But I mean, obviously Blunt is not good against undead, so it kind of just is what it is. I could have gone with it. That's why I said the Battle Axe is kind of best of both worlds. It's kind of like a really good all-arounder. And I was really tempted to go Battle Axe, I'm not going to lie. But I knew I was going to go Dwarven, and the Dwarven Warhammer looks really cool. So does the Battle Axe too, though, I guess. I mean, it's not too late. Like, it's not like it locks the other two perks. I could always just count this as a loss and just take the Battle Axe perk, so. It's not a big deal either way. Chest back here, right? I thought there was always a chest back here. Maybe I'm thinking a different part of the dungeon. Okay, so three power attacks to kill one outright. Did that waken the other ones? No, it did not. Okay, so that was like free. So I hit the unarmored ones for about almost like 180, though, it looked like. For some reason, I thought I swung the other way. I don't know. My brain, like I said, my brain is like not. Or I said this on the episode previous to this, but I did just record all of these right now. My brain is like non-functional. I just worked a 12-hour shift, but like I don't want to like not play. Because I want to keep recording this run because it's a lot of fun. Like, Avauntionzell is, that's probably the most fun run I've had of Avauntionzell in a long time. And thankfully, I don't think I need to do a lot of Draugr content on this character. Ah. I think I can kill her without getting hit by him. Wait, there's another one? How? Oh, I never did go get my auto looter figured out though. I'll go ahead and use another one. Because after this, I'm going to buy Breeze home, and then I'm going to actually make real potions. And I think I was working, what did I get to 50? I got heavy armor to 50. It's probably going to sit like that for a while, because I'm then going to do alchemy next, I believe. Or I was going to get heavy armor to 55 so I could get that stamina perk. There is another one. Okay, maybe I don't hit for that little. I mean, it is a little, but see, I think this is going to be the funny part of Jigalag, is I don't think I can even run through these without getting hit, because I'm too slow. Nope. See, I don't turn it off. I always leave it on, in case I got to run back through it. He's a level one. Oh yeah, I'm also not weapon canceling. I haven't felt like I needed it, but I could be. Yeah, so you can stand toe-to-toe with them, but, like, obviously you can see I lost half of my HP fighting this guy. And I don't want to use, like, one healing potion per Drugger. I'm pretty early in the dungeon. So. Oh, blue hand. I say I'm more scared of his ice magic than I am of the trap. Ah, I walked back into it. Why did it aggro this many? Oh well. I just wanted to pull the blue hand, but what are you gonna do? Well, I might be able to chill for a while. I'm gonna see how much how much health they regenerate on my own. So I'm missing like 150, so that's like 2 minutes. Cause it pulled like every Draugr in the universe, apparently. Oh, there's the one that's in here. Is he high level? No. He is a two-hander, though, so I do have to be careful. Being, like, very careful. Yeah, I'm just gonna have to use one. Like I said, I'm trying to reserve my, like, conserve my healing potions, not reserve, but... Barely got my block up. I was hoping that second to last hit would put him on his knee, otherwise I would have blocked again. So I've used like 5 healing potions already, I think. But I mean, considering the insane amount of damage that Draugr do, this is still pretty damn tanky. Now I think there's like 3 more chests, so I should have enough lockpicks now. Always take glowing mushrooms, they're an insanely good ingredient. Resist fire, resist shock, and resist... I believe it has all 3 elemental resists. Or that might be snowberries. Snowberries are really good, glowing mushrooms are really good. Kill this guy first. Hopefully he's on a shouter. I mean, we haven't had any shouters, we've been actually getting pretty lucky. I'm just playing really sloppy, but we've gotten super lucky on Draugr spawns. Oh, I thought I blocked, could have sworn I blocked that, looked like my block went up. There we go. Okay. Let's grab these. I carry weight's actually still not bad. I guess there's not a ton of loot in here, just at the very end. Okay, so it's to the right. Another fortified carry weight and another scroll of fireball. Cool. Because I know I still have resist magic potions. I'm going to save those for the boss. And then I'll probably use the two fireball scrolls and some other stuff. Because, like I preach, I'm going to try to actually practice what I preach, which is use your stuff. I saw somebody had a mod that puts a troll in here, which is pretty funny. Because then it actually makes it true what... the hell's her name? The Imperial that's in the shop. Where she says it's got traps, trolls, and who knows what else. So it actually has a troll. I don't remember it did in vanilla if it had a troll. I don't think it does. I think that's just like an error from... Or maybe it's not an error, but... You know what I mean. Weird dialogue quirks of Skyrim. Oh, I always go the wrong way. No, that's the right way. Yeah, it's just even more glowing mushroom. Hitbox OP. Am I overweight? Yes. Do I finally drop this sword? Or not? Oh. I can just drop this. I can go, I'll go to the silver mine at some point, maybe off screen. It's free, you just take the ferry to Carthwaisten and mine at the mine there. There's no combat. Oh, here we go, Shouter finally. Which means he probably also has a frost battle axe. Oh, that did hit me. I think I hit the terrain. Oh, I keep forgetting to turn on slow walk for my tower. Okay. He did not have an enchanted battle axe. Okay. I think there's... I think now there's like three chests left. So I might have just enough lockpicks to get through. You're dead. You're low level. I'm at full health, so go ahead and block you to get some stamina back. I'm getting super lucky with these Draugr levels, dude. I've had one Shouter. Real quick. Well, I said we were going to trap cheese a lot, but or that we were going to need to, but it turns out I didn't. Ooh, a good resist frost. Hell yeah. That'll be helpful if for some reason the Draugr at the end has frost breath. I know I think I've seen like one build where he does, like one iteration of the mods that I have where he does, but I believe he can have Disarm and Unrelenting Force for sure, and I think he can have Frost, but it's rare. I'm not sure. But Frost Breath, I think even with my resistances, I think would still kill me. But we're at a final room already, so this is actually going pretty smooth. I was playing really sloppy at the beginning, but Well, I mean, I always play sloppy, but I was playing sloppier than usual at the beginning. And we still made it through. This build is exceptionally forgiving. So, yeah, to any of you that are new, this is definitely a build I would recommend. A lot of armor, health regeneration. Like, the only place I think this is potentially going to suffer is going to be late game. Archer. That was nowhere near me, homie. That was also nowhere near me. Trying to anticipate his attacks because Warhammers are so slow, but that's already half my stamina, so I'm gonna chill for a second. Me that stamina. Give me that stamina. Give me that stamina. Except I missed because I'm retarded. These are all kind of just sitting there. How weird. Oh, I thought they were aggroed and they were just standing there. They were not aggroed. They're all low level, man. I can't get over like how lucky of a run this has been in terms of Draugr levels. I've had them all be, or not all be, but I've had like three of them be blue hands, one of them be a shouter, and all of that before you even get to the boss. What's running out? Oh, my fortify. Yeah, see, I used it a little early because now it's like I have to decide if I'm gonna use a whole nother one just for the boss, which I might, because I can always make fortify health, but I can't make. But I'd prefer to make fortify health versus make a new character. So. Wanted a little bit more stamina. I should just be able to wail on him. Yeah. There we go. Who was it that explained what this build was like? I think it was either Veggie or it was Tally's, one of the two. Basically said this is like playing. It basically just makes it like playing vanilla Skyrim in Requiem, which I think is somewhat true. You can kind of just like face tank enemies and trade blows until they die, and then you regenerate health. Oh, there's a shouter. Oh, cool. It doesn't knock me down. Oh, I think it was 45 and Forn changed it to 35. This is actually more than I meant to aggro, though, I'm not gonna lie. See, I'm gonna do the mistake where I get too cocky now and I run myself into a very dangerous situation. But I have no shame in using the traps, so. No way did I not block that. I'm actually just gonna. I don't wanna risk it. I have enough healing potions, there's no reason to not use one. Okay, that's one. What's annoying is, once again, my health. My fortify health is gonna run out right now. Stamina. You're dead. Oh, that actually went better than I thought. Much better than I thought. I want your diluted before I forget. So I think that's the one that fell. It is. And it's just this boy. Or girl, actually. Oh, come on. You're trolling. And I think my bestial's running out as well. I'll have to see how many Draugr are left to decide if I want to pop another bestial. I know I'm like hoarding resources that I don't really need to hoard, but it's just kind of the RPG player mentality where you just hoard all of your crap. That also would have been a good candidate for using one of the fireball scrolls. I'll say, let me just take this to make 100% sure that it can't knock me down, and it can't. So, 1100 health. You're a tanky boy. I don't know why I'm taking these. I have full stamina. So that's gonna hit me, but that's okay. This is also why we bought the Remarkable Tonic. It is a very noticeable difference from a Remarkable Tonic to a all the way down to a Deficient Tonic. Oh, there's actually a lot. How many is left? 1 minute. Okay. Oh, there's actually a lot left still. I thought that was the bulk of them, and it was, but there's still like five left that I can probably kill without. Ah, I thought I broke his bow, but he switched to weapon before I could. Ooh, Jesus, okay. Let's run a little bit. Archery OP, man. Pretty good haul of dilutes too. Ow, that one hurt. Oh, it's because I have less health, so the hits look like they're doing more because my fortify health is down. This might actually be not a good idea. Yeah, see, I burned all of my feints. I think I had like eight. But, I mean, I'm so slow, I can't really dodge anything, so it kind of just, you just eat shots. Kind of gonna wait for my health a little bit here. Oh, there's somebody behind me! What? So I've been getting hit in the back by arrows this whole time. I was kind of underwhelmed at first, but honestly, I think the Silver Warhammer is not too bad. And this is with 15% less damage from Jiggleg too. I'm just gonna run this guy out of arrows. I wanna get some of this health back. Oh, I could have gotten hit there. How many arrows you got? Jesus, dude. Alright, never mind, I'm not gonna wait. This is not. It's boring to watch and boring to play. Of course, there's a fucking blue hand. Fucking hate blue hands so much, dude. I was just talking about not running into any high-level Draugr, and then I almost die to one singular blue hand, and then I get stuck on terrain, so I almost die again. Wow, this guy is on my ass. I should have popped my resist frost there. That would have been a good idea. I'm gonna have to burn another one. Use a lot of healing potions. Way more than I would have liked. But I'm also bad. So this is an example of you can be bad at this game and still be just fine if you actually use what the game provides you and you plan accordingly. Like, I already knew that I had everything that I needed for this dungeon. Like that resist frost even, that's hand placed. So now you can run into blue hands before that, but all the other areas where you can run into blue hands, there's traps. So it's pretty much like if you see somebody's hand glow, just run immediately. And you're fine. So even though you're pretty resistant to damage, archery still, it kind of chips you to death. It's actually surprising how much damage archery does. Or it might just be because they're Draugr, so it counts as an... It counts as an ancient Horde weapon, so they get like plus 100% damage with it or something crazy. Jesus Christ, dude. Is that the ancient Horde Warhammer? That thing looks really cool. I should use, like, the ancient Nord set at some point as I get stuck on terrain because I'm talking too much. I'm trying to kite because I want to not use any more healing potions. I've already used so many. And this is what I absolutely don't recommend if you're new. When in doubt, pop a healing potion, always. It's just not worth it. I still have 35 minutes on my tonic, so I'll probably just wait to restore my health, and then I'll probably be fine without a bestial, to be honest. I don't think it gives me enough. I wish I had a... Oh, do I have a Fortify two-handed potion? No. See, this would have been a good time to have one. No, it's fine. So he has disarm. Okay. I don't know if that means he can still have... That's weird. I don't have the disarm shout replacer, but I didn't... Or maybe I do. Oh, he has a freaking ice sword, though. It might be worth popping my frost potion here, just because if I get hit by that thing, it's going to slow me, and then I'll get Vortex of Death. Kind of like what you saw what happened with the blue hand, which on any other character, I would have died there. He does have ice breath. Okay, I'm not going to risk it. Don't care. Still got hit. That's annoying. Man. Hey, hate fighting sword imports with Warhammer, dude. I said I'm probably just gonna have to trade, yeah. Just rely on the fact that I have enough defense right now. He's due to shout. That's what I'm really waiting for. There we go. Come on. Yeah, I only have 2 minutes left on my resist magic because it's a made potion, so it has less duration until you get really good perks. I didn't mean to do the sprinting one. Pop one more recuperation just to be safe. I thought he was an attack for sure. Now I definitely need to wait. See, I don't get that much, that one just didn't hit him. Oh, Jesus. Okay, well, we used an insane amount of potions in this dungeon, but we got through. Turns out Draugr are still scary. I mean, not really. Other than the blue hand and the boss himself, it really wasn't too bad. Another necklace of resist magic. Yeah, this has been a long one. Definitely not one of the quickest runs of Bleak Falls, that's for sure. Iron Boots of Hauling. I might take those and equip those right now. No, I'm at 166. And the last locked chest. Nothing. Okay, so we definitely did not get good, loot from here, that's for sure. Iron Boots of Hauling are okay. But the problem is, I gain 24 carry weight, but I have to take off my boots, which weigh 15. So I gain, like, and it reduces their... I'll gain, like, 15 carry weight overall by equipping them. It'd be a good enchanting ingredient if I was going to do enchanting on this character, which I am not going to because I'm going to be wearing the Ethereum armor. So just smithing and alchemy on this one. I know just two crafting trees, but I believe this one's not locked. Yeah. Had nothing, though. The flowers put me over. That's funny. Actually, red would have been better. That's okay. So I'm not making Magicka potions. So, that was Bleak Falls. Somehow we didn't die to that blue hand, even though I think I was down to like 10 HP. And there's another example of what I keep preaching but not practicing, which is if I had just used a fortify health, I probably would have been at like 40... Or I would have been at like 60 health there, which means I wouldn't have had the double slow movement from low health and low stam, just low stam, and I probably would have been fine. Like, I was one hit away from death there, and I kind of just got out of it by popping a bunch of potions and praying, basically. But it is what it is. We're going to take heavy armor. Is that enough? No, it takes... Okay, so heavy armor to 52, and then I think we're going to pump... It's tempted to start pumping two-handed, but I think the play is alchemy. Okay. That level me? Nope. All that was that I didn't even gain a level here either. Yikes. Okay, so all I'm gonna do is jump down and make sure my horse is alive, so I don't have to, because otherwise I'd rather deal with that stupid shit right now. And I gotta remember to switch my stuff around. Yeah, I never tried the Reverent, which is fine. I also didn't use my fireball scrolls like I said I would. See, what would have been smarter there is as soon as I saw that there was a blue hand with a bunch of other people, I should have just thrown a fireball immediately. And I think I had summoned Skeletal Soldier too. So, once again, said it once and said it 1,000 times. Use your stuff. Use your stuff. Okay. Oh, my Resist Frost is still up. As well as my Tonic. I wonder if there's any content I could do real quick for 24 minutes. There's little camps over here I could maybe do, but that'll obviously be in the next one. But yeah, that was Bleak Falls, another me playing like shit and almost dying but being saved just because the build is ridiculous. So yeah, hope you guys enjoyed.